Hello friends, today we are going to study one more important technique in the survey for collecting the information, and that topic name is aerial photogrammetry. Earlier we have studied about the various types of the surveying, including geodetic surveying, survey which is carried out over the terrain or over the ground. The main objective is same, to collect the details about that particular object and that particular ground that geodetic surveying we have studied in there. After that, earlier we have studied about one more technique, that is a hydrographic surveying, the survey which is conducted over the water bodies. The objective is same again, to collect the information about the terrain, or collect the information about the object which is related to the water bodies. The various techniques and various tools we have studied in there. After that, other techniques are also we have studied earlier, that remote sensing or remote sensing imageries and geographical information system also. In this particular topic, we are going to study the aerial photogrammetry. The name itself suggests that aerial means some part of the survey we have to carry out into the air, and photogrammetry means that extraction of the details on the terrain we can collect with the help of number of photos. So let us see, or let us go into the details into the aerial photogrammetry. First of all, introduction of the aerial photogrammetry. Photo means, we all know that it is a picture, either in a different format, that pictorial format. Grammetry means measurements of a different object in that elevation, distances, area, so etc. Therefore, photogrammetry is nothing but the photo measurements. So in the form of photo measurements, we can collect the information about the object, about the area, about the terrain on the surface of Earth. Photogrammetry is the practice of determining the geometric properties of object from the photographic images or from the photographs. It is the making of precise measurements from the photograph, the making of maps from the photographs, especially from aerial survey. So basically, in the aerial photogrammetry, the first part is to collect the photographs or imageries. Either we can extract the images from the other tools, which is remote sensing is one of the tool, or also that electromagnetic radiation, in the form of that we can record the images, and also photographs. So it is a science of using aerial photography and other remote sensing imageries to obtain measurement of natural and man-made features on the surface of the, for example, suppose the forestal area is there, how much area is covered on in the forestal area, also the area which is covered onto the water bodies, also the building, their location, the area, vegetations, city, different rock formations, so etc. There are many applications are there, and many features are there which is present on the earth surfaces. So that measurements can be done with the help of this method, that is a photogrammetry. In this method, the object are measured without being in touch, means without reaching that particular location. We can extract that information, extract the details about that object. So From this method, it is possible to extract the information without touching or without going or reaching that location. Next one, definition of the photogrammetry. It is a process of making surveys and maps using photographs. The science of deducing the physical dimensions of the object from measurement on images, usually photographs of the object. The making of maps by photography from the air using reference points, or we can say the control points of known levels and positions which can be identified on the photographs. The art and science of obtaining reliable quantitative and qualitative measurements through the use of photographs. So basically, we know that we have to collect the information or measurements about the object and about the area, either quantitative or qualitative. A series of techniques for measuring position and altitude from the aerial photographs or aerial images or remote sensing images. It is art, science or technology of obtaining reliable information about physical object which is present on the ground and the environment through processes of recording, measuring and interpretation of the photographic images. Photogrammetry is broadly required planning first and taking the photographs. The first of all, for collecting the photographs, the planning is important and taking the photographs, processing the photographs means interpretation of the photographs, measuring the photographs means assessment, identification of the photographs under the different instruments and equipments which are needed for the assessment and interpretation, and reducing the measurement to produce end results. So at the end, we require the data, we require the information, measurements in the form of different elevations, distances, etc. After that, the field application of the photogrammetry. There are various applications are there of the photogrammetry. Basically, we find the application in the surveying majority of the applications. Used to conduct topographical survey or preparation of the various maps like cadastral map, geological map, forestal map, topographical maps, etc. or engineering surveys. It is suitable for mountainous and hilly terrain with little vegetation. Used for geological mapping, which includes identification of land forms, different rock type, identification of the soils, their texture, their color, and their structure. It is also used for project demanding higher accuracy since it provides accurate measurements. Used in urban and regional planning applications also. Used mostly in planning, designing, in transport planning, bridge construction, pipeline construction, hydropower, urban planning. Apart from this, in security and strategic planning also, disaster management, that it finds the larger field application in the disaster management, natural resource management, city models, conservation of archaeological sites, etc. Importance of photogrammetry. It is used in different fields such as topographical mapping, architectural field, engineering, surveying, manufacturing, quality control, police investigation and geology, as well as by archaeologists to quickly produce plans of large or complex sites. And also it finds the application in meteorology or meteorological department. After that, photogrammetry, there are many advantages are there of the photogrammetry apart from the other tools which is also used in surveying for collecting the information and the data. But comparatively, photogrammetry has more advantages and very less disadvantages also. Let us focus on the advantages. First of all, it covers a larger area. It requires less time. This is a very fast process of collecting the information. It can reach to the inaccessible object, inaccessible location, inaccessible area or restricted area. It is cheap, cost effective for larger area and in a long run. In this method the photographs, it is easy to interpret and understand. Disadvantages: complex system, highly trained human resources needed, costly at the time of installation, means initial cost is high for taking the photographs and printing of the photograph, means automatic plotting machine is required for printing of the soft or the photographs in the soft copy. Heavy and sophisticated equipments are needed. The instrument and equipments are needed. Most sophisticated, most advanced type of the equipments are needed. For example, automatic plotting machine is there also for hard copy of the photograph. Lengthy administrative procedure is required to getting permissions to fly. Means that prior permission is required to conduct the survey on the particular area. Means correcting of the photographs. So we required the administrative approval or administrative permissions required. And at the last, one disadvantage is that it is weather dependent. Means it is not possible to record the images or taking the photographs in all weather. So weather is an important parameter. In a particular weather, we can record or we can take the photographs on the area. After that, types of the photogrammetry or types of the photographs. Basically, up till now we have seen that photographs are there, but there are different types of the photographs. The photographs used in photogrammetry may be broadly classified into two types depending upon the camera position at the time of photography. The first type is a terrestrial photographs or terrestrial photogrammetry. Second type is aerial photogrammetry or aerial photographs. Let us look at the terrestrial photographs. It is a photograph taken from camera station at a fixed position. Means the platform is fixed onto the ground or which is very near to the ground. Means the photographs are taken from the ground itself or ground-based platforms. That's why these photographs or this photogrammetry is called as terrestrial photogrammetry. Also, the photographs are taken by means of phototheodolite. Phototheodolite means theodolite is also used along with the camera. The most sophisticated cameras, more resolution, are used along with the theodolite, some other measurements. That's why that instrument, it's called as the phototheodolite, which is combination of camera and theodolite. Based on the principle that if the direction of the same object photograph from two extremities of major face are known, their position can be located by intersection method. That intersection method we have seen in the plane table survey. So the same principle we have to apply into the photography also, to locate any object or to finding out the length between the two object relative measurements. So as like in the plane table survey, which is used in the photogrammetry also. Next, this is a pictorial view of the terrestrial photographs. As we talk about that, it is a ground-based structure. Means that platform is there, either phototheodolite or some advanced cameras are used to take the photographs. So actually it is a ground-based structure, that's why it is called as a terrestrial photographs or terrestrial photogrammetry. Some height is also there of a platform, means ground based structure is there. For example, the tripod stand is there, and our phototheodolite or camera, it is fixed onto the tripod stand. So some elevated ground stations are also there to take the photographs. Method is very similar, that the camera is in stationary position. This is one of the differentiate point, that camera is at the rest or at the stationary position, and then photographs are taken. Camera using this method is called as a phototheodolite, because some angular measurements are also sometimes, or some triangulation work is needed to establish the control points. So that's why the theodolite is also, as a one unit is used, that's why it is called as a phototheodolite, as it required same features as a theodolite. It is a much cheaper and can be carried out by individual serving firms also. So this is all about terrestrial photographs. Then second important type, aerial photographs. Photographs taken from an aerial camera mounted on an aerial vehicle. So here, the various types of the aerial vehicles we can use. Aircraft we can use, balloons, rocket, kites. So these are the vehicles are there. And because they are going into the air, then with the help of camera, which is fixed into that vehicle, and the photographs are taken. Used for various purposes, mainly information extraction on the ground surface. Aerial photographs are obtained from aerial cameras mounted on aerial vehicles, such as aeroplane, for the purpose of photography. Used for various purposes, mainly information extraction on the ground surface. So basically, to collecting the information about the ground or about that particular area which we have to survey. So gathering of the information is prime most important. Photographs are taken from camera station in the air with the axis of camera, vertical or nearly vertical. So we'll study that about the axis or optical axis of the camera in coming slides. In that you will be clear about that, in which axis the photographs are taken. But mostly the photograph axis of the camera or optical axis of the camera is vertical or nearly vertical, means with the vertical some angle is created. That's why that angle is not a vertical, but something angle it is created. So that oblique photographs are also sometimes we have to take. It is a branch of photogrammetry where photographs are taken from air station. This is the best mapping procedure yet developed for larger objects and are useful for military intelligence. So this method is useful because larger area we can cover, and the applications for the military purposes. And also, if the area is large and object is large, objects are there, large area is there, coverage is large at that time, aerial photogrammetry is very useful method in their particular area comparatively the other previous method, that terrestrial. For this method, aerial camera is used, which are fixed on a flying aircraft. So I talked that aerial camera, that is the most sophisticated or advanced type of the camera, is specially designed for aerial surveying. That camera is used, and we have to fix that camera into the vehicle. Mostly that vehicle is aircraft. After that, aerial photogrammetry, basically that aerial photogrammetry is the method of collecting the information by using aerial photographs or remote sensing technology. Using, we know that in the remote sensing technology, the electromagnetic or energy or electromagnetic spectrum, like infrared, gamma ray, ultraviolet rays, are used for the images. Aerial photogrammetry or aerial survey can provide information of many things which are not visible from the ground. So that is one of the disadvantages in the terrestrial photogrammetry. So we can overcome that thing into the aerial photogrammetry. So sometimes when we are, our ground based structure is there, our camera is onto the ground based platform, at that time some of the things or some of the object we cannot see from the ground. So in that case the aerial photogrammetry is used because the larger area is covered, so that we can collect larger information of the larger area. Aerial photography or airborne imagery is the taking of photographs from an aircraft or other flying objects. Platforms for aerial photography includes fixed wing aircraft, sometimes helicopters are used. Unmanned aerial vehicles are also like drones, kites, rockets, balloons, etc. are also used. It is called as unmanned aerial vehicles. What field work we have to do into the aerial photogrammetry? First of all, the first step is flying. We have to fly into the air. After that, second step is to take the photographs with the help of camera, which is fixed, which is established into the vehicle. After that, the ground controls. So we have to take the photograph with the reference to the some ground based control points are there, which we have established with the help by using the triangulation, because triangulation work is already over. So we already identify the different ground points, and with the help of the ground points, ground control points, we have to take the photographs. And last step is plotting, means plotting of the photographs, because in the camera the photographs are stored in the soft format, soft form. We have to plot in the hard copy by automatic plotting machines are there. What are the uses of the aerial photogrammetry? The main uses of the aerial photogrammetry is a land survey, because there are vast applications are there, wide field applications are there in the city, in the administrative work, in the surveying department, in the disaster management department. That land surveying is important. Coverage area, how much area is covered, how much area is affected, how much area is disaster. So the land surveying part is there. Also it finds the uses in mining engineering also. So extract from the oil fields, gases. So that, for that also the aerial photogrammetry or aerial photographs are used. Archaeological departments are also using some older historical monuments or historical structures to continuous observation and collecting the information about that area. The archaeological department, it finds application. Monitoring wildlife and insect population. So you know that in the forestal area there are various wildlifes that exist, and their population, their counting of the population census or inspect the population, we can use this aerial photogrammetry. After that, main important part why we are using the aerial photogrammetry, because some other conventional tools, methods are also there, maps, because ultimately we have to collect the information, collect the data. For that we can also use the maps, because there are various maps are already prepared. But we are going the most advanced techniques, because we have to cover the larger area, and also the accuracy is one of the important parameter, quality, and the most accurate measurements we require. That's why we are going to the aerial photogrammetry. The main differentiate point, it is in the maps we are taking the linear and angular measurements of the ground, but in the aerial photogrammetry it takes photographs of a terrain and showing all the details. Elevation of object determined directly by plotting contour, because many of the times we have to finding out the elevation of object. So by contour maps we can easily find the height or elevation of the object. But in the aerial photogrammetry, elevation of object cannot determine directly. Some procedure is required, but we cannot directly find the elevation in the aerial photogrammetry. Plotting and reading common to users, because in the maps there are signs, symbol, signals of various objects are shown onto the maps. But in the aerial photograph, it is not familiar to the all of us or users. It needs a special type of the techniques and special type of the tools to read. Maps are economical because it is not that much of costly is there. So it is economical method for collecting of the details and then preparation of the maps and then collecting the information or data. But comparatively, it is aerial photogrammetry is uneconomical because initial cost is more, or because for the flying and taking of the photographs and then into the hard copy photographs are used. No confusing details and easily recognizable. So there is a no confusing detail, as we know that it is a signs and symbols are clearly mentioned onto the maps. That's why there is a no confusing details. Easily we can identify the objects and area. Easily we can read. But comparatively, we can see into the aerial photogrammetry or aerial photographs, confusing details are there. We cannot easily read, easily identify the objects and the no distortion caused by tilt and relief displacement. So there is a displacement, it is caused because of the tilting, because of the our photographs are tilt somewhat with the vertical. That's why the object or the images are displaced from their true position. So distortion of details of terrain caused by tilt and relief displacement in aerial photogrammetry. After that, the types of the aerial photographs. There are mainly three types of the aerial photogrammetry: vertical photograph, tilted photographs. Sometimes it is unintentionally tilted. And third is the oblique photograph, intentionally tilted. In the oblique photograph, again there are two types: low oblique photograph and high oblique photographs. In the figures, you can see easily that in the first figure that vertical photograph, the vertical view of the area, you can easily see that your optical axis is truly at the axis of the gravity or coinciding the axis of the gravity. That's why the maps, clearly the plan of that area, you can easily see. In second picture, you can see the low oblique. There is no horizon. You can see into this picture some angle it is created, some tilting has been made with the axis of camera. That's why you can see some details easily. And in the third picture, that high oblique is in there, you can see the horizon and larger area is also covered. So that is the optical axis is somewhat higher angle it is created. So in this picture, you can easily compare that vertical photographs, because aircraft is there and exactly below the area is covered, that vertical photograph has been taken. So better for making maps and plans, these vertical photographs. And oblique photographs are used for pictorial effect. Larger area is covered and perspective view you can see into the oblique photographs. So below you can see the two photographs, photograph of a vertical photo. This plan you can see, and somewhat angle it is created. So camera axis is tilted. That's why it is called as oblique aerial photograph. Next, you can see into this picture, vertical photograph. Here, the camera center or camera lens is there. Means this particular position is in the aircraft at the center of the lens, and this is vertical photograph, means this optical axis is exactly vertical. So axis of the gravity and optical axis or camera axis is exactly coincident. And this low oblique photograph, high oblique photograph, camera orientation for various types of aerial photographs. And in there you can see the maps in the grid format or grid lines. Vertical photographs, you can see the easily planned, you can easily finding out the measurement distances and area. in the low oblique photograph, and this is a high oblique photograph. In there you can see the horizon. Vertical aerial photograph. It is an aerial photograph taken with the camera axis, as I taught that camera axis or optical axis coinciding with the vertical to the ground is known as vertical photograph. So this is a picture or is a photo. You can easily understand that camera lens film is there at the top, and plumb line or axis of gravity you can see, and this particular area is covered onto the terrain. Second type, that tilted photograph. What is meant by tilted photograph? An aerial photograph in which the camera axis is unintentionally tilted by small amount. The amount is less than 3 degrees, and the tilting is has been turned from vertical or perpendicular to the ground is known as a tilted photograph. Means angle it is created between the plumb line and the axis of the camera is less than 3 degrees. Third type, that oblique photograph. It is an aerial photograph taken keeping the camera axis unintentionally tilted. Keeping the camera axis intentionally tilted from the vertical is known as oblique aerial photograph. Means in the previous method, tilted photograph, the camera axis is tilted unintentionally, and in this particular method the camera axis is tilted intentionally. So that is the main difference between these two methods. The main advantage of the oblique photograph is that they cover larger area, and they also provide side view or perspective view of the area or features. Again, oblique photographs are also of two types. One is a low oblique and second is a high oblique. Oblique photograph in which horizon is not seen, as you seen in the photograph picture, that horizon is not seen. A tilt is up to 30 degrees. And in the high oblique photograph, horizon is seen. You can see the horizon. Tilt is more than 30 degree and less than 90 degree. So this is a tilt or angle between the plumb line and the optical axis of the camera. In the low oblique, tilting angle is 30 degree, and in the high oblique, tilting angle is 30 to 90 degree. So in this picture, you can see that the camera lens is there. Here it is not a vertical photograph, or it is not a tilted, it is a oblique photograph, low oblique and high oblique. So you can see that this dotted line is plumb line, and again this second dotted line is somewhat inclined, so that is the camera axis or optical axis of the camera, and in between the angle it is created that 30 degree, and this particular area is covered from this camera or exposure, this area is covered. In the second picture you can see this high oblique camera axis is also there. This is a horizon area, is they are going for the larger area. Plumb line is as it is, and angle is somewhat larger, so that this is the camera axis or optical axis of the camera, and the angle is more than 30 degree. Here it is somewhat 40 degree angle is as shown. So I think you understood about the low oblique and high oblique photographs. Means smaller angle is created in the low oblique, and somewhat larger angle is created. That's why, means larger angle means larger area is covered, smaller angle means smaller area is covered. Principle of the aerial survey. So this picture is very much important, because you can see this is a plane, or we can see the when the photographs are taken, the plane or the different points are important, because in the previous picture we have shown that optical axis and the plumb line, axis of the gravity, direction of the gravity means truly vertical, and angle it is created. So we'll see in detail about each and every points and terms, but we can define that each and every terms in the next slide. So this is also figure. You can see that the plumb line and the optical axis, the angle which is made, and this is the plane of the photograph, and this is the center of the lens or center of the camera, angle of tilt is created here. This is the axis of the tilt, and this is the ground or ground surface is there. Definition, one by one we will see that all the terms, all the important terms are there into this particular photogrammetry. Exposure station, as you know that exposure station O is nothing but here that O is the center of the lens or center of the camera, which you can call it as the exposure station. So the point in the atmosphere occupied by center of the camera lens at an instance of photography. So I think you understood about the exposure station in the center of the photographs, which is in the air or in the aircraft. Flying height. The flying height means truly elevation of the aircraft or elevation of the camera. It is a vertical distance between exposure station and the mean sea level. So normally elevation or height is measured from the datum or from the mean sea level up to the exposure station or camera center. Flying line, flight line, next important line traced by exposure station in atmosphere. Line traced by exposure station in atmosphere means it is a track of the aircraft. So number of photographs are taken in a line, that's why it is a track of the aircraft. Photon principal points, photo principal plane is the point which is available on the photo. It is a point on a photograph obtained by projecting camera axis to intersect at a point on a photograph, which is known as photo principal point. Camera axis extended up to ground, the point obtained on a ground is called as a ground principal point. So there are two principal points. One point is available on the photo, which is small k, photo principal point. Another point, if you extend that line over the ground, that point is called as a ground principal point, capital K. Next, photo nadir points. So that both of photo nadir point, which is previous one term is that plumb line or axis of gravity. It is a point on a photograph obtained by dropping vertical line. So it is a truly vertical line, which is sometimes plumb line also called, from the camera center. That plumb line extended up to ground gives ground nadir points. So small n, which is available onto the photo, and capital N, which is available onto the ground. Horizon point. It is a point on of intersection of a horizontal line through center of lenses and principal line on a photograph. Principal plane. The plane defined by exposure station O, ground nadir point capital N, and ground principal point capital P. So in the figure you can see that that plane is capital N OK. Next, azimuth. Azimuth means many of the times angle which is created or angle which is major with respect to the magnetic north direction. So in the figure also you can see that phi, it is a azimuth angle, that it is major clockwise horizontal angle major about the ground nadir point from the true north to the principal plane of the photograph. So in the figure you can see that azimuth angle phi. Swing. This swing is also one of the horizontal angle, that angle measure in a plane of photograph from positive y axis, and it is measured clockwise to the photo nadir point. It is called as a swing. Isocenter I. I is also mentioned onto the photo, that picture. Point on a photo where bisection of tilt falls on a photo, which is shown by dotted line in the sketch. That point it is called as isocenter. Axis of the tilt. It is a line in a plane of a photograph perpendicular to the principal line at the center. So these are the different terms are important, so that it is briefly defined all the terms, and with the help of you can easily study that all these terms with the help of that picture in the previous slides. So this is all about the aerial photogrammetry. We have studied all the terms, and all the terms which is included into the aerial photogrammetry. We understood about the aerial photogrammetry. We understood about the terrestrial photogrammetry. and how in the modern days that aerial photogrammetry is used, or it is a very advanced tool which is used to collecting the information of a larger area, and within a we can also reduce the time. Within a shorter time also we can collect the larger information by using this aerial photogrammetry. Thank you.